foreigners living inside of Hong Kong, they see themselves as someone who cannot speak freely, highly monitored by all these different surveillance equipment. And also they are so afraid that anything they say, you know, could be a threat to state secret or, you know, anything that could put them into trouble. Because Article 23, remember, is very broad and also very, very vague. And then, you know, those, even like talking to foreigners in Lan Kwai Fong, right, where my office was, which you went to, I think, there are a lot of foreigners. So by talking to someone who doesn't look Chinese, would I be more at risk as being framed as communication with the foreign power, right? Who knows? So there's a lot of fear factor living in Hong Kong. And let me just rephrase and also remind you one more thing. You could be jailed for not reporting others, right? So you would play the role of like in George Orwell's novel. Big Brother is watching you, but at the same time, you have to report someone who is doing something wrong. If you don't report, you are also in trouble. You could be jailed for a long sentence. I think 14 years, right?
This is how the CCP always does it. They get people to turn on each other. You can't trust anyone. It's communism 101.
Yeah. And your legal rights, honestly, there isn't much, right, with what's going on now. Your legal rights detained for like 48 hours, no lawyer, and then they could still detain you for up to 16 days. And after that, if they think, honestly, you are a threat to the country, I don't think they will abide by this 16 days rule. They could do whatever they want. So this is my perception of the new NSF, which is the Article 23 under the Basic Law now. And thanks to John Lee and Chris Tang.
So we were in Hong Kong for the 2014 umbrella movement. And then when we went back like 2 years later, it seemed like everything was really subdued and they're like no one really wanted to protest. But it was clearly under the surface somewhere. Because then just a few years later in 2019, the protest movement exploded and it was over something slightly different. But essentially, I felt like there was this this anger at the CCP that had been under the surface for 5 years and then reemerged. It's now been almost 5 years since the last Hong Kong protest. And there's a lot of more restrictions, right, on protesting. You basically can't go protest. But are you seeing, or do you feel like there's under the surface Hong Kongers in Hong Kong feel this kind of anger and this desire to protest? They just don't feel safe doing it, or there's not like a trigger yet, or what do you think's going on there?
Inside Hong Kong, I think the flame will die. It's sad to say this because they use many different methods to silence you, subdue you, and to scare you. I can't remember who you interviewed, but for instance, like Denise Ho, the singer, right? They confiscate her passport. They haven't laid charges on her yet, but she cannot leave Hong Kong. We talked about Cardinal Zhang just now. He is like 92 now, right? Passport confiscated. I think he got a special permission to visit the Holy See once, right? But then that's about it. And then those who interview in 2014 and 2019, how many of them are in jail or cannot leave Hong Kong? All of them. So it speaks very clearly that even if you go back this year, there isn't too many people for you to interview.